Okay, hello, welcome back to hell. I am SIMSteven, also known as Mr. Federal. Either way, yeah, a slightly better mood today. Maybe not as bad of a mood as last episode. Yeesh. Still hate this place. Still not gonna sugarcoat it at all. Worst place in the game, right here. Liangshan Forest. Though, excuse me, already getting the voice cracks here. Good news is we've finally gotten the last of. We were right there. I was about to say we got the last of Jakar's spell abilities on his Chaetex here. Now we just got his last Chi attack period. So now we can actually give him some halfway decent moves. So I'm going to put on our Shaker, Overpower, and Life Leech. That way, he is pretty much going to... Actually, I tend to give everyone added blow just out of principle, because it's just straight up a secondary attack. And I might just give Jakar Life Leech and Sacrifice. And also keep Overpower and Earthshaker, because he can be a real powerhouse with these abilities. And Earthshaker, well, we'll probably have to wait for another enemy to show this off with. That one was just about dead before we learned that ability. But yeah, Jakar has that Earthshaker ability, which is unique to only him. And I think it's basically just the same effect as the Basser on steroids. So let's find ourselves a victim and test it out on him. Let's see if we can. Yeah, it's pretty much he pounds the ground and they fall down. So once again, you can force trip, at least for the most part, with the Earthshaker ability. And this makes him broken as hell, including if you have a Debasser on him. But like I said last time, as soon as Jakar would learn his final ability, I'm going to be switching back over to Fleece, since I generally prefer to play as her more than anyone else. As well as the fact that everyone else can cover the healing in Fleece, well, since she doesn't have any other magic besides the Dark family of magic. I like to play as her so everyone else can focus on healing. And speaking of which, I always forget to do this. I forget to summon my monsters and use them, even though I de-summoned him. Banished him, I should say. When we were crossing the poisonous fog. I forgot to pick him up and re-summon him after we got through that barrier. So, now, I guess we're just going to look around this village a little bit more. I don't think there's anything that we were missing over here. Oh, and by the way, let's actually look at our map real quick here and just kind of go over things a little bit. So last time, we got over the first hump of this place, of the M shape of this place. Today, I think we're going to get over the second hump. Happy Wednesday. And I think we'll stop right before we get to any sort of events near the end of this place. There should be some quests we can make some progress on once we get a little bit further north, maybe a little bit on the east side. I forget exactly where this place is, but there should be a cemetery that we've heard about from our quest givers, and should be along the road a little bit further here. Thankfully, this part of the road is a little bit barren, so we can just kind of scoot right on by and get at this place over with quicker than... The faster this place goes, the better. Oh, there's a cemetery. It's right there on the left. So we're going to have to go in there. Wow, that's kind of weird. I don't really remember it looking like that. Thinking maybe I tried blocking as many memories of this place out of my mind as I possibly can. Still hate this place. Yeah, we're going to take care of a few quests while we're in there. I think there's also some... By the way, what do I have for Fleece's chain attack skills? Kick, mug, trip. Do I want to have kick on? I'm thinking here. The reason I have kick is because it's the only way for fleece to deal blunt damage, but it's not exactly necessary at this stage in the game. But blunt attacks for fleece will be important, and by that I mean her kick ability. Later on in the game, once we get back to Medivh, because a lot of enemies, once we get to Medivh, will be immune to swords, which is the only thing that fleece can use. Well, that's classification damage, which I think is slashing, or is it piercing? I think it's actually piercing. I think axes are classified as slashing, and staves are blunt, obviously. Blunt weapons are blunt. You are an enemy. There's a couple few friendly Onis here in the cemetery here, and I actually have to talk to them to proceed with a few of the quests. So we'll do that while we're here. But yeah, like I said, both of Fleece's weapon types, swords and bows, are in the same family. And that makes it hard for her to actually do damage late in the game. So kick is how she's going to be doing damage later on. And it's going to be kind of annoying when it gets to some of those enemies later on. Anyway, let's start in the back and work our way back to the entrance of the cemetery. This guy is just a regular old Oni. Oni glides, eyes you warily as you approach the graveyard. Why have you come to this place? The spirits of Liangshan are evil, and they will do you harm. So leave the coin and lock it. Follow Feng Ying's instruction. You place the Yaoming's coin and the Chao's locket on the stones of the Liangshan graveyard. Your kind help those in need, the Oni says. Do what must be done here and go. You are in danger here. At least this one's friendly. Well, I was playing Onigiri right now. All the Onis would be friendly, but not this place. And the Onis in Onigiri are a lot more human looking than these guys here. Either way, do not fear me, travelers. I will not harm you. This is Piaobo, or is it Piaobo? I'm not entirely sure how to pronounce this guy's name. Who are you? My name is whatever I just said. I was born in the village of Wolong on the Lake of Sorrows. We lived in a hut at the water's edge. My grandfather was a fisherman. My mother looked after his birds. Mother, she told me my father was a soldier. Handsome swordsman who died in battle, but she lied to me. My father was a spirit of the forest. As I grew older, I changed. My skin withered and hardened as if I were an old woman. My face turned into an ugly mask. The other children made fun of me until I began to frighten them. Ew, I know that feeling. Growing up with a birthmark on my knee that looked like it was some alien put it there. Yeah, I kind of know how this guy feels. I could not leave the hut, or villagers would throw stones. They told my grandfather that if he did not get rid of me, they would drive my family out. That's when my mother told me the truth. She said I was a child of the spirits, that I had to go live with my own kind, so I came to Liangshan. The Oni do not harm me, nor are they kind. Every day I become more and more like them, cruel, spiteful, and angry. I am forgetting what it means to have been a girl who lived on the Lake of Sorrows. If someone does not help me, the girl named Piaobo will die. And it's a girl. I thought it was a guy for a while, but either way, I was lost forever. Only the spirit remained to haunt these woods, but I can find no one who will help. Well, what must be done? To become a girl again, I must sacrifice my immortality. Oh, if only that were so easy. Spirits of the forests are immortal. Though you destroy their bodies with swords and spells, these spirits will never die. She shows me a small box, a small, simple wooden box. Wow, that kind of does sound like Zelda fingers. The box contains my immortal spirit. Wow, how'd you do that? You're a mortal spirit, eh? I must sacrifice the box. The Dragon of the Lake. Will you help me? Yeah, sure, why not? We're probably going to be going back there eventually anyways, to turn all these quests. Bring this box to the caverns of Wolong, throw it into the abyss, and I will be free. Please do not open it. If you do, my immortal spirit will be lost forever. Okay, well, we can't actually open it, even if we wanted to right now, but once we get back to Wolong, into the ice cavern there, We'll be able to make a choice, and I think the obvious choice would be to throw it in the pit, and not open it. Either way, we got ourselves another full body armor just there. No, I don't want to quit the game. I want to equip that thing. It was, I think, Adamant Bogodil? I believe that was what it was called. And since Jakar is wearing the regular Bogodil, I'm going to take a look and see how much better that is, since apparently it's going to be better since it has an adjective attached to it. Okay, where are you, dude? Well, still got a huge inventory, and it's getting bigger by the day. Alright. Protection 40, speed 1.11. I think that's the same as what we had. Is this piercing plus 2, equipable by Jakar? So it's only a difference in 5 protection, so I will take that. And now he's got... excuse me. My throat's going dry here. I don't know why, the last couple weeks, I suppose, my throat has... I don't know if it's been reflux or what, but my throat has been scratchy and I kind of feel a bit of, well, stomach acid's coming up as if I did have heartburn a lot, but it comes and goes. Oh. Joseph, please stop. Please stop. That is a weird glitch that can happen sometimes, if someone is trying to cast a spell from just slightly out of range. Look at Joseph's AP right now. It is gone because he's glitched into purely casting that spell over and over again. Thankfully, spell shortcut glitch does fix it, but now he's out of AP. So, well, whatever. He was just kind of glitched in the same animation. He was just constantly starting and stopping the spell because apparently I think he was out of range just slightly. But his AI kept casting the spell anyways, and he kind of got into a glitchy loop of a mess there. Like I said, this game was not the best made because it was a launch title for the system. Yeah, today, speaking of where we are today, today I plan to travel back to the southeast and stop just before the bridge, which is where the first boss fight of this place is. And I guess I should say first. let's see here. Also, we need to find, what's his name's hat, I think? But yeah, I did say there are two bosses here. One's not technically a boss, per se. But we do have two boss fights coming up in the future. Come on, I wanted to open the box. What's in the box? Spike mace, okay. It's a good thing these guys are dropping lots of weapons, because that's going to be our primary source of money in the future. And if we want to buy everything that we can buy here in Orania, before we end up leaving, because that time is coming up pretty soon. Yeah, we're going to want to get as many weapons from these guys as we possibly can, so I can reduce the amount of time I'm going to be grinding on the world map, so that I can get some money to buy the stuff. Either way, Grey Dragon skill, right there, pretty much at the northern wall before we go back down to the south once again. Also, I'm getting this little spot on the map here because it didn't look like I had it. Yeah. Always a cartographer I am. But either way, there's some Onis over there. I'm going to go fight him real quick. And look over there. On the other side of the riverbank here, you can kind of see it. That is the shrine we're looking for, and maybe once I kill these guys, we'll be able to get close to the riverbank and see it a little bit better. And that is our ultimate goal of this place, is to go back over there, and that's where the shrine is in the Guardian of the Forest. The Guardian of the Forest is, and he has the ring that we're looking for. There's about 100 more Onis in between us and it. Also, one thing I've forgotten to mention at this point. Another good reason why the Basser is such a strong weapon is once it knocks an enemy down, Flay should just run up behind him and backstab an enemy. And this is also another reason why I like to play as Fleece, is because if you equip Jakar and Joseph with the Bastards, they both have a chance of tripping the enemy just with the regular attacks, and it complements Fleece's skill set because she can backstab an enemy when they're on the ground, and it's able to hit in its max damage range. What's that? Did you hear something? Yeah, we do kind of hear a lot of things. Even though there really isn't much music, it's kind of got a creepy swampy thing? I don't know. But apparently Rosalind heard something. I didn't really hear anything, even though I got headphones on. Yeah, this is also the best part of why the Bastards and playing as Fleece are such good ideas, because look at how fast we're going through these Onis now. Backstab them? Oh, Jakar got a critical hit. Never mind. I should be able to backstab this guy if I can get around to the back of him. I didn't get my backstab off in time because, well, they both got knocked down at the same time. Yeah, this is pretty much the best strategy to use once you're able to buy the Bastards over in the merchant over in the desert. Anyway, let's go. Let's kill this guy real quick. That's also a disadvantage of having too many healers in your party, is if you get slowed because you're walking around an enemy and they hit you, and you... Well, you just saw what happened. All four of them hit cast cure on me at the same time. Either way. Yeah. We now have a real good party going for us here, and should be fairly smooth sailing through the rest of this dungeon until I get to that bridge, and I actually should go back and poison myself in the poison fog, because once again, be very careful with the glitches that this place can have, and I tend to make sure to have the poison going before I hit any scripted events, just because I don't want to do anything that the game doesn't want me to do. Because I don't want to have one of those game-breaking glitches that happens as a result of this game being a launch title and being poorly programmed. Either way, backstab this guy off, and one more should do it. There we go. Good. Still does a lot of damage, even if they are aware of your presence and all that. But it does like 5 times as much damage if they're on the ground. And let's see if I can actually get it off one more time on this mate. Nope. Mages do tend to have a lot less health than the fighter type enemies anyways. Either way, we should be coming across that bridge pretty soon here. Might be able to even see it in a second here. And that's about where we're going to stop the game, or stop the episode, because I don't want to cross that bridge just yet. Alright, that one's on the ground. Please get around. Please do not attack me. So that I can backstab this guy. 800 damage. I don't know if that was with the bonus damage. I think it was with the bonus damage. It's been on the low end because it only did 800. We've seen it do over close to 1,000 here today, so... That was almost 1,000. Oh yeah, once again, the power of backstab is great. One of the best things in the game. Alright. I'm in a good spot. Look at how much health he had. Look at how much health he doesn't have now. Over 1,300 damage. I love that. If you couldn't tell already. Anyways, we're going to stay towards the right wall because as you can see... A little bit of a cave over there, and over that way is the water, and the bridge that I'm trying to avoid. Yeah, we're not going to do the bridge just yet. I'm going to do that next time. This guy, I think I can take him out. There you go. One hit kill. Well, it took a few hits just to get him knocked down, but you know what I mean. I went the rest of the way. Also, look at how much health I got back because I got everyone set on healer. It just shot right back up. One of the reasons why I love having everyone on heal, because having Joseph and Jakar on healing duty so they can melee the rest of the time makes it a good combo to use with the Debasser. And everything's all working together, finally. Anywho. Oh. Is there anything up here? See, there's a little cavern there. We'll go in there in just a sec. I do believe there's a quest item down there, if I'm not mistaken. And there's that bridge. I'm definitely not going to walk up to it just yet, but we are going to go around this side real quick. And we're going to go into the cave below this twisted tree here. And see if we can't find any goodies besides the one quest item that I know is in here. Okay, so I see two items in here. And what is this? Some skeletons. Looks like this is where the Onis put their food. Or maybe there's some adventurers here. Maybe some Renians came wandering to this place and got killed. Ring of Shadows. Oh, we've already had this one, I think, before. If not, maybe a Necklace of Shadows. Alright, so good for me if I ever decide to sneak again, which I don't think I will. And there's the blank parchment. Once again, we need to get this thing for the Secrets of Dokkanim, which we only picked this quest up maybe 20 hours ago in the gameplay-wise. back in Iona, someone asked us to get something from the Secrets of the Dokkanim quest, and now we finally can actually make progress on that one. Anywho, I think that's all there is in here. Good thing there's no enemies, at least. So let's go back and maybe kill a few more Onis and then call it a day. I'm just going to clear everything out before the bridge so that we can get ready for the events of next time. Also, I should also be doing this. Trip! It's a chain attack skill! If you go back before between Trip and Mug, you can make it easier to backstab an enemy. And make it even more powerful than it already is. More cheap than it already is to use this combination of abilities. Alright. I should start putting points into Fleece's Trip skill because it will become more valuable in the future. Especially when she can't do much to the enemies in the future that are immune to basically all of her attacks besides her blunt attacks. It'll be good to make it so that her trip skill actually triggers a bit more often. And I have higher chances of getting it to go off. And I'm not getting the chain attacks going. Alright, there you go. Someone tripped and dumped. And dead. There we go. Alright. I think we might be at the end here. There's the bridge there. And you might want to zoom in there if you're looking at the screen here, because there might be a couple familiar friends over there that we've seen before. You know what? I'm going to leave that for next time. Instead, I'm going to sign off here. I am SimSteven, also known as Mr. Fenrel. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time where we're going to get ourselves into a fight.